لبيك يا حسين لبيك يا حسين لبيك يا حسين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My name is Kazim Ukka. I live in South London and I'm a graduate from the London School of Economics, LSE, in International Relations and History. Aside from my education, my main passion is reciting nohas and qasidas and nasheeds in honor of the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. And alhamdulillah, I've had the privilege over these past few years of recording and reciting my own nohas in honor of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Since I was young, the name Imam Hussein has been quite possibly the most important name in my life. Since I was young, I've been, alhamdulillah, attending various majalis and azadari programs, julus, and I feel that this embodies the spirit of the Shia community as a whole. Of all the members of the Ahlul Bayt, we've grown up learning, you know, all the way from Rasulullah to the 12th Imam, ajalallahu ta'ala faraja. But the name Imam Hussein is a name that evokes such great emotion in our hearts, because every single year we gather from the beginning of Muharram until Arba'een of Imam Hussein alayhi salam in order to commemorate the tragedy of Karbala. So for me personally, the name Hussein is the most important name in my life. Alhamdulillah, the first time I visited Karbala to perform the ziyarah of Imam Hussein was when I was only 4 years old. And I feel that for many of us that have had the opportunity to visit Karbala, especially at a young age, this generates a deep attachment to Imam Hussein and the martyrs of Karbala from a very young age. And that attachment and that fire in our heart will never diminish. And from the first time that you visit Karbala, you only tend to appreciate it, in my opinion, when you return back home and you realize the emotions and the profound love and passion that you felt when you were in Karbala. You realize that this is second to no experience you would have in your life. So you always have this genuine passion and this drive to go and perform the ziyarah of Imam Hussein later on in your life. And alhamdulillah, for me, the last time I was there was Arba'een last year. So for me, I've had, alhamdulillah, the opportunity to visit Karbala a number of occasions in my life. And each time that you go, your love of the Ahlul Bayt and of Imam Hussein in particular grows. And I would highly, highly encourage those of you that haven't performed the ziyarah of Imam Hussein to go and do so, because when you return, you'll come back a changed person, a changed Muslim, and also someone with an even deeper appreciation for the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. So in terms of the first experience that I can remember, this was in 2010, and alhamdulillah, we had the opportunity of visiting Karbala as a family. And since then, I've found that I've developed a far greater love for the Ahlul Bayt and for Imam Hussein in particular. And the most recent time that I visited was Arba'een of last year. And for those of you that have been for Arba'een, you'll, you know, realize the significance. I think just on Arba'een Day alone, there were about 15 million people in Karbala. And you see these huge crowds of people chanting Labbaik Ya Hussein, Labbaik Ya Abbas. And for me, visiting Karbala generally is, you know, a life-changing experience. But in particular, if you visit during Ashura and Arba'een, if you walk from Najaf to Karbala, when you eventually reach Karbala, and on Arba'een Day, if you have the opportunity to go inside the holy shrines, this is an experience that you'll never ever forget. You'll remember the atmosphere, the deep sorrow and grief that you had, you know, everyone, you know, crying profusely out of love and sorrow for Imam Hussein alayhi salam. It's truly, truly a moving experience which I don't feel you can get anywhere else, especially as a Shia. You'll never get this experience. So in terms of the Arba'een trip that I went on last year, this was the first time I'd been for Arba'een, and for many years it had been my passion and my ambition to perform the ziyarah of Imam Hussein during Arba'een. Unfortunately, because of, you know, education, I wasn't able to. But what I would say is that whenever you have that desire in your heart, if you constantly have this Labbaik Ya Hussein in your heart, inshallah, Imam Hussein will accept you as his Zair. So I visited last year with my dad and two of my cousins. Unfortunately, due to time restrictions, we didn't have the opportunity to perform the full walk. However, I did perform a couple of hours of the walk. So we landed in Baghdad, we performed the Ziyara of Kazimiyya, and from there we went by road towards Karbala. And just before entering Karbala, myself and my cousin got off and we continued walking into Karbala just to get a taste of the experience. And just within those couple of hours, those were two of the most memorable hours of my life. There are people offering you tea, there are people offering you food, there are people, you know, with tents and all sorts of other amenities that are, you know, welcoming you. Even though we came from, you know, the UK, my cousin came from Kenya, you know, we still were welcomed as lovers of Imam Hussein. That's ultimately what we are, and that's a big sort of factor within Arba'een, is the unity that it brings. And one thing that I remember very well are there are many, you know, life-size models of the scenes from Karbala. For example, there was a life-size model of Hazrat Abbas just near the Furat, you know, picking up water that he was, you know, going to bring back for Sayyida Sakina and the other children. And, you know, these are, you know, real emotions and images that you're not going to get anywhere else. And eventually when we did approach Karbala, for those of you that have gone to Karbala, you'll know that the first shrine that you see is Hazrat Abbas's shrine. So we walked up the street, and when the dome and the minarets of Hazrat Abbas alayhi salam fell upon our eyes, you feel that strong sense of emotion that you can't believe that I'm here. And finally, I've had the opportunity after 20 years of my life to visit Karbala. So alhamdulillah, it was such a memorable experience. I can remember each and every footstep of the trip. And how it works when you go on Arba'een is, on Arba'een night, there are a number of congregations or juluses that are going to the shrines. So you start at a particular point. We joined one of the juluses. You first visit the shrine of Imam Hussein and Hazrat Abbas. So this was through the night, an 8-9 hour Azadari procession. But then when you eventually come inside the shrine of Imam Hussein, we got in just after Fajr time. The emotions are so great that you know, everyone was crying around us. Everyone was so, I haven't seen so many expressions of grief, even in all the majalis I've been to. Everyone's emotion in the haram, it's completely full, the courtyard. It feeds into you and you feel that emotion. And I can remember literally crying my eyes out when the Masaib of Aba Abdullah was being recited. And then you proceed to the shrine of Hazrat Abbas alayhi salam. Of course, going through Bainul Haramain. Bainul Haramain was absolutely jam-packed, not even any space, you know, barely any space to move. So, you know, as I said, Arba'een, 10 to 15 million people in a small city in one day is absolutely unbelievable. And there are world records showing that Arba'een is one of the world's largest peaceful gatherings anywhere in history. So, you know, you look at that and that demonstrates the power that Imam Hussein brings. I tell you, there is no one personality in history that evokes as much love and unity and passion as Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Even though he stood in Karbala alone 1400 years ago, crying out, "Hal min nasirin yansuruna?" We are all answering this call when there are millions of us that march towards Karbala, chanting Labbaik ya Hussein. This is us pledging our allegiance to Imam Hussein, saying that we will never let your message die. Of course, with the great rush that there is in Karbala during Arba'een, you'll be very, very lucky if you get to touch the shrine inside the internal dariyah of Imam Hussein and Hazrat Abbas. So on the days just before Arba'een and the days just after Arba'een, alhamdulillah, I had the opportunity, with great difficulty, with the crowds that there are, to cling on to the shrine of Imam Hussein. And in terms of my du'as, of course, you remember your parents, my brother, who's extremely dear to me. I made du'a for him and also for the rest of my family. Whenever you go to Karbala to perform the ziyarah of the Ahlul Bayt, before praying for yourself, always pray for other people, especially those other Shia and Muslims and humanity at large that may be suffering around the world, because surely there is no greater interceder and no greater personality that you can pray through to reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than Imam Hussein alayhi salam. There are many narrations saying that if you make a dua underneath the dome of Imam Hussein, that this dua will be accepted. And there is actually a small spot, a small stone just next to the dharih. It's a red stone on the floor, and this is in line with where the holy head of Imam Hussein is buried. And they say that if you make a dua there, especially if you pray a 2 rak'ah salah there, that whatever dua you make at this time will inshallah be accepted. And of course you also go to the shrine of Hazrat Abbas. Hazrat Abbas is Babul Hawa'ij. You know, no doubt he is one of these personalities that if you pray to pray towards his shrine, pray to Allah through Hazrat Abbas as an interceder, many people go and tie green cloths on his shrine. You see many people with disabled children or family members that physically tie them to the shrine of Hazrat Abbas, because this is the power of Hazrat Abbas, the patience and the loyalty and the sacrifice that he showed and he gave on the day of Ashura has granted him such a high status that we can't even begin to comprehend the status of Hazrat Abbas alayhi salam. So when you go to Karbala, make whatever dua is in your heart, and inshallah, because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's love of these holy personalities, he will inshallah grant these du'as for you. So for those of you that have visited Karbala, of course you have Bainul Haramain and the two holy shrines. But within the vicinity of these shrines, there are also various maqams. So the maqam of Janabi Ali Akbar, the maqam of Janabi Ali Asghar, the two spots where narrations state that the two arms of Hazrat Abbas were cut. And you go to these various maqams, and that helps you really to visualize the tragedy of Karbala. And one place in particular I can say that I felt a great deal of emotion is the maqam of Hazrat Ali Akbar alayhi salam. And this is the very spot where when Hazrat Ali Akbar was shot in the chest with a spear, Imam Hussein came towards him and held him in his lap until Hazrat Ali Akbar breathed his final breaths. This is a spot in which, alhamdulillah, I've had the opportunity to recite the masaib in noha form of Hazrat Ali Akbar alayhi salam. Especially when you visit, for example, when I visit with my father, and you realize the love that you have for your father and the love that a father has for his son, that my father has for me, then you can't even begin to imagine the emotions and the feelings that were going through, you know, the hearts of Hazrat Ali Akbar and Imam Hussein on the 10th of Muharram. So really, when you visit Karbala, you have a visual perspective of the day of Ashura, which you otherwise won't have. You also have the tents of Imam Hussein. And one thing that always goes through my mind when I visit these various spots in Karbala is the distance between the Khaymaga and the shrines, and which were sort of the main battlefield at that time. It takes you a good, you know, 10 minutes, 15 minutes to walk from the Khaymaga to the other parts of the battlefield, as it would have been back then. And you realize and you remember how many times did Imam Hussein have to run out of the tents towards the battlefield to lift the bodies of Hazrat Ali Akbar, of Hazrat Qasim, when he took Hazrat Ali Asghar out, when he bid farewell to his brother Hazrat Abbas. You realize in this great state of thirst and sorrow and emotion how much Imam Hussein had to go through. And this is one very, very monumental thing that you begin to feel and comprehend when you're in Karbala. Also, in my opinion, one other thing to consider is that you're visiting, you know, Karbala, Najaf, Kazmain, Samarra, but ultimately you're entering the country of Iraq. And especially when you've gone, you know, in the early 2000s or the 1980s and 90s, you know, Iraq was under the tyrannical rule of Saddam Hussein, and it was, you know, embroiled in various repeated wars under this dictator. And even when you go there now, there is so much devastation, there is underdevelopment in terms of infrastructure, there are so many orphans and widows. Just in Karbala and Najaf, there are various orphanages and, you know, orphan schools. In fact, the Haram of Imam Hussein, the office of the Holy Shrine, actually has a number of orphanages that are under its care. And it goes very far in embodying this message of humanity, embodying this message of humanity that Imam Hussein brought by helping out these orphans and these widows and these impoverished people. So when you drive, for example, from Baghdad to Karbala, or Karbala to Najaf, or Karbala to Samarra, you see the rubble on the streets, it brings about a great sense of appreciation in your heart, realizing that for those of us coming from the West, how alhamdulillah, how privileged we are to be living here in a country that, you know, hasn't been in a physical war over here for many, many years. And then you travel to, you know, the Middle East and you realize the devastation that there is. That's another aspect of ziyarah. You'll develop that appreciation. In terms of my personal emotions when visiting Karbala, it's a profound feeling of peace, of infatuation, and of course of sadness. When you stand in front of the dhariyah of Imam Hussein, and especially for me standing in front of the dhariyah of Hazrat Abbas, and you recall the masaib of these individuals and you visit the various maqams in Karbala, of course you have this deep feeling of sorrow that you're not going to get anywhere else. Even if you're in a majalis, of course you'll feel sorrowful and aggrieved. But when you're actually standing, you know, at the spot in the, for example, the Qatalga, where Shimr physically sat on the chest of Imam Hussein and beheaded his holy head, then you have this real sense of emotion where you don't feel anywhere else. And saying that, and one thing that always goes through my mind is 1400 years ago on the day of Ashura, this was the most chaotic place in the world. There was this battle, there was so much bloodshed, there were babies being killed and orphans being killed and elderly people from the army of Imam Hussein being killed. There was the burning of the tents on Sham-e Ghariba. There was so much tragedy taking place. But when you visit Karbala now, it's the most peaceful place on earth. You see the golden domes, you hear the birds chirping, you may hear Adhan or Quran or Dua Kumail or Ziyarat Ashura or any of these supplications being recited, and you truly feel that you're in Jannah. In my opinion, Karbala is a piece of paradise on earth, and anywhere that you go, and alhamdulillah, I've had the opportunity of performing my Umrah or visiting Iran as well and other holy cities in Iraq. Karbala for me is unparalleled in terms of the deep emotional feeling that you get when you're there. And one thing that I would also say is that a lot of the time you don't tend to appreciate where you are when you're actually there. It's such a surreal experience that you feel, of course, like I said, you feel so much emotion and sorrow, but this emotion and sorrow really kicks into your heart when you come home. As soon as you open your door and you go into your bedroom on that first day that you've come back and you're there alone, you realize, oh my God, I was in Karbala, I was next to my Imam. And that's when the emotion really kicks in, when you have this appreciation and this gratitude that I got to visit there. Immediately, as soon as you return home, what goes through your mind? When will I get to go back to Karbala again? Of course, the time when we visit Karbala is only limited. Most of the time you're only there for between 5 and 7 days. And eventually when you have to leave, you have this deep regret and this sorrow. When you have to go and perform the Ziyarat al-Wida of Imam Hussein and the other martyrs of Karbala, you do not want to leave. You hold onto that shrine and you don't want to let go, because the emotion and the closeness to the Imam that you developed over those past few days was something so special. And for those of you that have been, you'll know when you leave. A lot of the time when you're leaving Karbala, you'll go over a bridge. And if you look out, I believe on the right hand side, you can see the shrines of Imam Hussein and Hazrat Abbas in the distance. And you see them and you give your farewell. And at that point, you know, whenever I leave, I always have tears in my eyes. And at that point, it's very highly recommended when you're leaving, pray that Allah gives you the opportunity to visit Karbala again in the future. And as I said, it's a very, very sad feeling, but you should also have a sense of gratitude that there are many people that might not have got the opportunity to visit, but I did get that opportunity. So of course, do a, you know, 2 rak'ah Salatul Shukr in the holy shrine, thanking Allah for giving you this wonderful, blessed opportunity. And if I had to summarize in one sentence or one phrase, the ziyarah of Karbala, it's simply the best experience of my life, especially during Arba'een. It's something that you'll never forget. And like I said, something that when you go once or twice, you'll want to keep on going. And that's, in this way, it changes your life. And for me personally, when I visit Karbala and when I come home, I've developed a far stronger spiritual connection to the Ahlul Bayt, and especially Imam Hussein alayhi salam, because as I said, Karbala gives you a very, very special feeling as a follower of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Alhamdulillah, the first time I went to Karbala in 2002, we were lucky enough to bring back a painting of the shrines of Imam Hussein and Hazrat Abbas in the background as well. This has been hanging in our living room for, it's been 17 years now, and I don't think it will ever be taken down. And whenever anyone enters our house, whenever of course we, you know, come and sit down in this particular room, you always see this on the wall, and you remember your journeys to Karbala, you remember the emotions that you felt, and you develop this strong longing to want to return to Karbala as well in the future.
Labbaik ya Hussein, labbaik ya Hussein, labbaik ya Hussein, labbaik ya Hussein, labbaik ya Hussein. Labbaik ya Hussein, labbaik ya Hussein.